Squad 1 to Overlord. Scanning for hostiles now. I'm detecting some strange interference.
Republic fighters, evade!
Great shooting, people. Scratch 1 destroyer.
Looks like the captain of the destroyer is making a run for it.
Got their engines. They're not going anywhere.
Great shooting. Let's regroup.
Commander!
General Dayrun, what can I do for you?
I'm glad I caught you. Darth Malgus is assembling one of the largest attack fleets in history. We need your help.
What else do we know? Do we have the fleet's objective?
We should discuss that in person. We're in the operations center on Karak Station. Please hurry, Commander. Dayrun out.
More than 100 capital ships, with smaller picket ships and support vessels close by. And that's not all. There's enough fuel transports for all those warships to cross half the galaxy. Darth Malgus is leaving nothing to chance. His fleet won't stop until they reach the objective.
Which is?
Corellia.
It's a pleasure to see you again, Master.
I never had the chance to properly thank you for your help on Ursus. Many people owe you their lives.
The fleet's target is the Meridian Complex, a state-of-the-art shipyard that's due to begin production in a matter of weeks. The Meridian Complex can produce new warships at triple the speed of any existing shipyard, and at half the energy cost.
Once that shipyard becomes operational, it could give the Republic a significant advantage in a matter of months. That's why they're committing so many ships to this mission. The Sith Empire will stop at nothing to destroy this new shipyard before it can save the Republic's war effort.
The Alliance has warships, but not enough to challenge a fleet that large. Where do we come in?
It's crucial that we redeploy the Republic fleet to defend the Meridian Complex immediately. Unlike Malgus, we can't move our ships to Corellia without refueling stops. We expect the Empire's top agents to target our reinforcements anywhere they stop. They won't risk our forces arriving in time to make a difference. We want you to defend and expedite those reinforcements as best you can. If we defeat the Empire at Corellia, we turn the tide of this war in our favor.
All right. Where am I going first?
The planet Onderon. The 11th Fleet is gathering there to resupply and refuel before heading to Corellia. It's the only Republic port within range of their current position.
Onderon has been a Republic world for centuries, but local politics have become strained and fractious. Tawadar is already investigating. She suspects Imperial infiltration.
I'll be glad to work with Tau again.
She feels the same way. You made a very effective team on Ossus.
General, word from the 87th.
I'll leave you to it, Commander. Good luck.
Speaking of Tau, I have one more favor to ask of you, Commander. Arn, if you please.
Commander, been looking forward to meeting you. I'm Arn Perallan, Jedi Padawan.
Aren't many cyborgs among the Jedi.
I hadn't noticed.
Tau had to leave for Onderon before I could introduce her new Padawan. Since you're heading there anyway, I thought Arn might ride along with you. The Commander is one of us, Arn. Heed her well. May the Force be with you both.
Artillery fire. On Dacot 7.
What?
How'd it happen? How'd you get injured? Yeah, that's everyone's first question. My master and I were escorting refugees. He died. I survived. More or less. Dacot 7 has advanced technology, but the locals can't use Kolto or Bacta. Genetically incompatible, they said. So they use cybernetics to treat all their severe injuries. Their recovery took years. I don't know if I can still become the Jedi I hoped to be, but I'm not giving up now.
The Force is strong with you, Arn. I can feel it. I'm sure you'll become a great Jedi.
Thanks. It feels good to return to the Jedi path after so long. Hey, before we go, my new master, Tao, what can you tell me about her?
Tao has all the best qualities we aim to uphold. She's courageous, dutiful, determined. She'll teach you well.
Master Nostral thinks very highly of her. Glad to hear you share his opinion. Thanks. I'm ready when you are.
Lana, I'm heading for Onderon. Gather up anyone that's free and meet me there.
Understood. We'll set out immediately.
So, what do you know about Onderon, Arn?
Well, we just landed in the heart of the capital. Not that there are any other major cities. The planet is mostly wilderness. The wildlife is famously dangerous. The plant life is hardy enough to seed barren planets and spark new ecosystems. So that definitely makes Onderon an important resource world. What else? The planet is ruled by a king named Petrith, who's been on the throne for just over 3 years.
Impressive. Somebody did their homework.
Oh, I can't take the credit. Master Nostral gave me the full lecture back at Carrick. You know how much he loves history.
Let's find Lana and hear what she's learned about the Imperial's plans.
Lana Beniko, right? The Sith Lord that works for you?
Lana isn't like most Sith. You've got nothing to worry about.
I have to be honest, I've never talked with a Sith before, you know? So, after you?
Commander, welcome to Onderon. This must be your new friend, Arn Paralan. Jedi Padawan.
Nice to meet you.
Why don't you tell us what you've learned so far?
Of course. Onderon is a powder keg. King Petrith has been at odds with his noble council for months. From what Theron and I have learned, he wants to strip mine the planet to line his coffers. The nobles aren't interested in that plan. As a result, Petrith has changed residence to his hunting lodge in the wilderness, where the nobles can't keep track of his activities or visitors. The nobles are led by Senator Nebet, the planet's Republic representative. She was kind enough to lend us her office. Nebet's people have detected coded transmissions from the hunting lodge. The code used is highly sophisticated, and not Onderonian.
An Imperial code?
Nebet suspects as much. I have Dr. Ogorob analyzing it to confirm, but in the meantime, the Senator is preparing the city for a potential attack. To that end, our people are spread across the capital, shoring up the city's defenses. I believe you'll find Tau Adair in the central marketplace.
Good work, Lana. I'll take Arn to meet with Tau. Can you arrange an audience with Senator Nebet?
Certainly. I'll contact you once I have the details.
All right, Arn. Ready to meet your new master?
Ready as I'll ever be. It was nice to meet you, Lord. Lady,
Just Lana will do.
Commander, it's good to see you again. You must be Arn.
Yes, Arn Paralan. I look forward to learning from you.
Great. Well, let's get started.
Sounds good. So, where should we start?
I have no idea. Wow.
Why don't you walk Arn through what you're doing out here?
Right, of course. I checked in with the guard station up the street, and now I'm gonna check the walls for...
We're under attack!
Get to the palace. Coordinate with Lana.
Right away. Arn, are you ready? Arn!
I'm ready.
You're heading for the explosions?
I'll let you know what I see. Stay in contact.
You got it. Let's move.
Some of them are wearing Onderonian uniforms, but the rest, no clue. They're definitely headed for the palace, Commander. We'll slow them down as best we can.
Master Zhou would be proud.
Step away from the controls. Now.
Gladly. It makes no difference now. The firing sequence is already locked in. My calculations leave no room for error or intervention. You may defeat my remote droids, but not before the orbital defense cannons obliterate the Republic fleet. All units, begin combat recording protocol, Orek. Let's see what you're truly capable of.
Let's see what you're capable of now. Injury? Very impressive.
Republic fleet, raise your shields. Imperial forces set the planet's defensive guns to fire on you. I'm disabling them now, but they may have other tricks up their sleeves.
Understood. Shields up!
We'll pull the fleet to a safe distance and maintain alert status.
Tau, this whole attack was a diversion. The Imperials tried to use the defensive cannons to attack our fleet, but I managed to stop them.
That's great to hear, but I'm not sure anyone told these guys they're just a diversion. Think you could give us a hand in the throne room?
On my way.
World still has great value to the Empire. Think of the resources. Think of the strategic position.
Worthy objectives for another day. Our focus is Corellia. The Emperor has made that clear. Evacuate your remaining forces and go to Rendezvous Point 1. And Savik, the next time I call, you will answer in person.
The nobles! Nabet! They'll have me imprisoned! You promised support! You can't leave me!
Go with my droids, King Petrith. They will keep you safe. Onderon will bow to you again soon enough. You again. You continue to best even my most aggressive estimates. Quite rude.
Leaving so soon? I was looking forward to catching up after all this time.
Don't pretend. You don't remember me at all, I'm sure. This is a neutron emitter. Once fully charged, it will emit a wave of energy fatal to all organic life within range. The range is just enough to engulf the whole building, and the effect lasts for hours. Once you're dead, my droids will have plenty of time to fortify the building against further incursions.
Can we be running away?
You can try.
I'm getting a bit better now.
So what's the fastest way out of here?
The balcony, obviously. If only someone had been brilliant enough to order that remote piloting system for our ship. And to start flying it here at the first sign of trouble. What genius could have accomplished it?
Great work, D4.
Thank you.
How about the guards in the East Corridor?
Yes. I feel two of them. They're nervous, but it's a general concern. Nothing threatening.
Dead on. The North Corridor.
Three. But they aren't guards. They feel different. Kitchen staff, I think.
Right again. But can you sense the Commander's Sith friend down in the armory?
No. I can sense the guards there, but no one else. Can't even sense a Sith Lord. Not much good, am I?
I don't sense her either. But that's because she's actually out checking on the main gate. Your friends will make mistakes. Your enemies will lie. Your senses can be deceived. But you can always trust what the Force tells you.
Seems like your training is going well.
Thanks. It's all coming back to me, but there's still so much to learn.
Thank you for your patience. The nobles would rather debate who was most wronged by the King's treason than decide on a course of action.
We were right about Darth Savick and King Petra. The Sith manipulated him into attacking, but they both managed to escape.
Any hints about where they might go next?
Darth Malgus ordered Savick to leave Onderon, but nothing beyond that.
I think it's time to pay a visit to the other attackers. The Untamed, to fight for the Sith. The Untamed must have been manipulated even more effectively than the King. I'm sure they're all the more frustrated for it. They know the wilderness better than our finest scouts. They have both the motive and means to help you find Savick.
All right, how do I find them?
They'll be in mourning now. I made sure their dead warriors will return to them, to comply with the traditions they hold above all else. Light the appropriate beacons as you approach their hideout, and they will treat you with something like respect.
If Senator Nebet agrees, we'll gather volunteers from the city guard. As soon as you find Savick's location, we'll be ready to launch a coordinated attack.
Of course. Onderon will see justice done. Good luck, Commander.
Koru, we honor the fallen. Offworlder, you observe our rites and customs. You show the respect due to the true masters of this world. You may speak your purpose here. Just be quick about it.
I'm looking for Darth Savick. Do you know where she is?
One Offworlder seeking another. Why should we be involved?
Savick betrayed you. If you tell me where she is, she'll face justice. If you don't, you'll be helping her escape.
Justice would be feeding her to Okoro's beasts, alongside Nebet, Petrif, and all others who spoil our world with the influence of outsiders like you. For now, we must lick our wounds and regain our strength. Kill Savick. Take her prisoner. So long as there are less of your kind here, we will celebrate the ancient proving grounds. Your city dwellers will know where it is. Savick thought she could hide a ship there. From other ignorant offworlders, perhaps. But not from us. You will find her there. Petrif, too. Now go! We will never suffer your presence here again.
The shuttles were pretty well hidden, but we've got a full sensor lock. Now that we know where to look, they won't leave without us knowing.
Volunteers from the city guard are ready and speeders are prepped. We can be there in minutes.
Tau, Arn, you'll take the volunteers and attack from the far side. Make a lot of noise. Draw Savik's attention. I'll go on foot and catch Savik off guard.
No, this is Malrev 4 all over again. That's not how I remember it.
The Proving Grounds are ancient and dangerous, even without Imperial patrols. Be cautious. If you manage to find Petrith, please bring him back. The sooner he faces justice for betraying his people, the better. An exiled king can tell his own version of the story, rally supporters, and cause endless trouble. A man in prison is a memory that quickly fades.
I'll do everything I can to bring Petrith back to you.
We are incredibly fortunate to have you for an ally.
Sensors are picking up energy blooms. Might be the shuttles powering up. Better move out.
Everyone look out for each other. Stay in contact. We're almost done. May the Force be with us.
So fast. The diversion was impressive, but I know your moves too well to be fooled by a mere imitation.
You're not going to escape, Savik. Just surrender.
Ah, Melora would have enjoyed this. The insect, threatening the spider from within its web, she'd say. I sometimes miss her particular insanity. You're clear for launch, Petrith. The sensor jammers will activate when you exit orbit. You'll be all but impossible to track.
Await my return, dear Onderon. You shall know the splendor of my rule once again.
Let's ensure a bit of privacy while we're at it.
Shuttle 2, commence aerial assault on hostiles in Zone 5.
Now then. I've prepared for this day for so long. Where to even begin? You struck me down in my prime, then moved on without a second thought. Corellia would have been my tomb had my droids not found me. In truth, I should thank you. You made me what I am. Taught me the best way to move forward. I haven't risked direct combat in a decade. I send my droids, or manipulate fools like Petrith to fight for me. But now, at last, the Force has reunited us. I've spent years studying you, crafting the ideal response to your every tactic. Shall we test what I've learned?
I regret harming you. If I had any other choice now, I'd take it. You have another choice now. Take it. Revenge can't heal. It can only destroy.
Then let it destroy you! Supposed to make me stronger. all of my rage, all of these years. It still wasn't enough. I've studied, trained, risen to the Dark Council. What does it take to beat you? How can you be so powerful?
I'm strong because I fight for others. The Force is a part of all living things. How could anyone hope to master it when they only focus on themselves?
Please. It's clear that I'll never beat you. I don't think I even want to anymore. I just want to understand. I can't return to the Sith now. Not after this. They cannot help me become more than I am. Only you can.
Hey there. Sounds like we won.
Everyone all right?
Some of the city guards were hit by the airstrikes, but we're pretty sure they'll make it.
Looks like you have one prisoner. Was Petrov in the other shuttle that launched?
Yes. He left as soon as I got here.
I can help you. You can easily track him down with his sensor jammer's algorithm. I'll give you the algorithm. Whatever you want.
Yeah? How about the other fleets the Empire is targeting? Where will your friend strike next?
Nekshar. It's an old mining outpost that was converted to a fueling station. I don't have the details, but that's our, Malgus's next target.
Really? Just like that?
Let's get back to the palace. We can sort all of this out there.
Sounds good to me.
Then Savik's cooperation is sincere? She's actually told you the Empire's plan?
Seems that way. I checked with General Daerun and we have a fleet headed to Mekshaw for refueling. The pieces fit. Arn and I will head there right away to meet with the fleet's commander, see if we can start rooting out the imps. If we can stop them on Mekshaw like we did here, we might just stand a chance at defending Corellia.
Have any of the Republic's other reinforcements come under attack?
Not yet, but we have all ships on alert. Let's hope they don't try anything else as elaborate as they did here. See you on Mekshaw. Senator, thanks for everything.
Safe travels.
We've got Savik on an Alliance shuttle ready to move out. She says she wants to stay with us. Well, with you, mainly.
Of course, the Republic prefers that we transfer her to their control. How would you like to proceed?
Take Savik to Odessa. She could become a real asset to the Alliance.
Right away.
Please don't make us find some other idiot to work for. That is, we'd much rather work for you.
We'll be glad to have you. Lana can set you up with quarters back on Odessa.
Oh, that's just ridiculous.
We have your ship fueled and ready whenever you wish to depart.
Using Savik's information, we've sent troops to follow King Petrov. We expect to have him back in a matter of days. His trial will be interesting, of course, but I'm more concerned with what will come after. If the nobles can't agree, the question of leadership could turn violent.
The nobles will have you to guide them. They'll make a smart choice.
Thank you. I can only hope you're right. Good luck on Mekshaw, Commander, and on Corellia.
Commander, this is Vice Admiral Narlok, commanding the Republic 29th Fleet. Welcome to Mekshaw.
Narlok? You served on the Essilies, didn't you? It's been a long time.
It really has. I'd hoped I'd have the chance to work alongside you again. I have a local contact who's helping me arrange refueling for our ships. Your Jedi friends are already here. Send me coordinates now. Narlok out.
Thank you.
place, huh?
Commander, this is Jot, an old friend of mine. He served 30 years in the Republic Navy, and now he's Mekshaw's chief engineer.
Call me Junker. Everyone does. And chief engineer's a bit fancier than we like around here. Me and my crew just keep things running. Lights, water, atmosphere. Mekshaw's neutral officially, but me and mine will back the Republic to the end. Whatever you need, we'll help you get.
Thank you for lending us a hand, Junker.
Not often I get to help a Jedi. It's a pleasure.
Junker's been working to get us the fuel we need, but it isn't as easy as I'd hoped.
Like I said, Mekshaw's neutral, so your ships don't get topped off until the powers that be vote on it. See, Mekshaw used to be run by the Hutts. The locals kicked them out while they were distracted with McKeb, then started running things themselves. So all the big decisions come down to a vote by the leaders of the five biggest crews. Lucky for you, I'm one of them. Hutbreaker, she led the revolt. So now she runs the docks. She'll vote for you. Fuel sales go straight into her pocket. So you just need one more vote.
Unfortunately, I'm no diplomat. And sorry, Junker, but neither are you.
So you need us to get the last vote and stop whatever the Empire has planned. What else did Darth Savik tell us?
We're dealing with Darth Shar. She's the Dark Counselor in charge of Imperial logistics, which doesn't sound very scary.
Maybe. But you don't make the Dark Council just by getting supplies delivered on time. Never underestimate a Sith.
If you're looking for Sith, they'll be with the Brothers. Bunch of creepy slavers down on the lower levels. Empire is their biggest customer.
We can bet they'll show up in force as soon as the fleet starts refueling. We'd better plan out our defenses ahead of time. Could Arn and I scout out the docks a bit? I'd like to see what we're dealing with.
Of course. I'll take you myself.
We'll catch up with you later, Commander.
All right, just us now. No need to put on airs. I know what you're thinking, because I think it too. You've got a whole big fleet out there and a tiny rock full of lowlifes here. Why not just roll in and take what you need?
These people aren't our enemy. Forcing them to give us their fuel would be wrong.
Good answer. And on top of that, it just wouldn't work. Hutbreaker has a failsafe rigged up. Push a button, it fires a pulse that makes all the fuel on the station inert. Takes weeks to make the fuel useful again. Not the way you want to go, trust me. I got a much easier route for you. Hutbreaker's hosting an auction at her stronghold on the other side of the station. All the crew leaders will be there, and I can get you in. It's your best chance to start winning that last vote.
What is Hutbreaker auctioning off?
Couldn't even begin to tell you. All sorts of crazy stuff passes through Mekshaw. Crossroads of the galaxy. Now, let me just get a few things sorted and we'll get you on your way. What the?
Who are you?
Saber. Sith trying to take you out already! In the middle of my turf!
None of this adds up. Why wear a mask if his lightsaber gives away who he's working for?
Don't ask me why Sith do what they do. I always figured the ones who wear the mask just don't feel scary enough without them. Speeders that way. I'll meet you at Hutbreaker's place in a bit. Gonna put more droids on perimeter security. Blasted Sith think they can just strut right in here!
Be too nervous to even talk to her.
Fancy meeting you here, boss.
We were catching up with Theron and Lana, and they mentioned you were here. Figured we'd lend a hand.
We've cut a few deals with these people over the years. With our help, you'll know just how to play them. They'll vote however you want.
I'll be glad to have any information you can give me.
Just doing our part. If you're ready, let's head inside. All right, first up, Hutbreaker. Revolutionary leader, liberator, and unofficial queen of Mekhsha. Her crew runs the main docks.
She won't need much convincing. Selling that fuel will bring in a small fortune, but that only stands if you keep the peace. You get too messy with any of these gangs, Hutbreaker will lock things down, no matter how much she stands to make. Keeping Mekhsha safe is her top priority.
All right. What about the brothers? Jot mentioned they work with the Empire.
Yeah, they're slavers, all part of some weird religious cult. The Empire buys most of their stock.
A lot of the refugees who come through here end up in the brothers' pens, and Hutbreaker isn't above throwing troublemakers their way, too.
Needless to say, you won't be getting their vote for anything that helps the Republic. Better to focus on the other crew leaders. First is Veet the Snake. He runs a Rhodian smuggling ring, the Harito Wald, one of the biggest operations in the galaxy.
Veet's a businessman. He can be anybody's friend if there's an upshot for him. Just have to figure out what he needs and make sure he gets it. The other crew leader is Indigo, Mandalorian. Well, ex-Mandalorian. Same with his crew. They're called something like
Darmanda. They're mercs and gunrunners. Indigo has some kind of rivalry with Veek, so it's a good thing you only need one of them to vote your way.
Veek or Indigo? Got it. I appreciate your help.
What are friends for?
Looks like Hutbreaker's about to give her big welcome speech. Let's find a good spot.
Mekhsha! How are you doing tonight? Look at us! We are surviving! We are thriving! We are turning this tiny rock into the beating heart of the galaxy! Just a few years ago, we were slaves! Now, we're masters! Imagine what we can become in just a few more years! All we've got to do is stay us. Be what we've been so far. We keep the peace, we keep the balance, and we keep moving forward! We've got the whole galaxy laid out in front of us. Everyone else just doesn't see it yet. All they see are the soldiers, politicians, Sith, Jedi! All the people who think they run things, who think their wars decide who's in charge. The truth is, they'll never be in charge. They'll never really run things. You know why? Because while they're busy killing each other, we're making deals, making friends, expanding! Everything they buy so they can blow each other up. We're selling and getting richer, stronger! By the time they stop and do the math, it will be too late. Because there will be a lot more of us than there are of them. And then, it will be us calling the shots. So stay the course, my friends. It only gets better from here! Welcome to Mekhsha. Did you enjoy the speech?
I can see how you were able to inspire the rebellion against the Hutts.
Well, the Hutts did most of the work for me, if I'm honest. Someone just had to fire the first shot. Now then, please, enjoy our hospitality. Have a drink on me and keep the peace. You can keep the peace, yes? Narlok gave me his word.
Servants of the Republic often espouse high ideals, even as their deeds tell a very different story.
No need to be rude. Commander, this is Darth Shar.
Dark Counselor in charge of production, logistics, and civil order. How do you do?
What brings you to Meksha, exactly?
Oh, a few minor import-export violations that I wish to resolve. Nothing terribly interesting. I'm sure refueling your warships will be much more exciting.
I'm sure the two of you have a lot you could talk about, but we do have a previous appointment. Enjoy the auction, Commander.
I do hope we get to meet again soon.
Do you lead the Brothers?
We are a brotherhood, united in noble purpose. We have no leader. Our path is obvious. We take beings without value and give them value. We give labor to those who suffer without purpose. Our works enable greater works. Our labors create laborers. Useless beings are made useful again. The galaxy is made better.
Forcing someone to do things against their will is wrong. Slavery doesn't make the galaxy better. It destroys lives.
Activity can only create. Idleness, apathy, inaction, these destroy. Your words waste breath that could be used productively. This entire event is a waste. We will witness no more of it. What do you want?
To the point. Let me return the favor. I'm looking for some help. Interested?
If you think Darmanda want to fight and die in your little war, you're out of your mind. We're doing just fine on Meksha.
I'm here to get your help with our operations on Meksha. No fighting needed.
Interesting. Depending on the details. Look, this isn't a good place to do business. Too many years. Maybe they can't handle that, and we'll see.
Chonki faguta de opora geotokakise. De monte que caça do bonilis de oto. Chai con kunta chi chai.
It depends on how well you treat your friends.
Ma kipuna male tutta o mishka. Conchita chichakta. Kusa mala chikuta. Ikosa mose ala tuta. Koba ne puta. Taise jeskusku.
I'm curious. What's your stance on fueling the Republic ships?
Asliali koyaran kenka kurum. Kliskataka, jos osko uko pokuta. Makipuna mali tuta od mishka. Kusa mala chikuta, ikosa mose ala tuta.
The sooner the better.
Pampaula kavaji oto.
I'm sure we can figure something out.
Tungi machechu. Kafstu undile, jio hola lukuta. Tungi machechu, kutsi nankihe. Wana wa de bloto wijawa.
Had enough fun for one night?
I'm finished here.
We heard about the assassin earlier. Glad you're still in one piece. They should have known one Sith wouldn't cut it with you.
Did they send anyone after you or Arn?
Not yet. It really is strange. You're the toughest of us all. Going after you one-on-one was a total waste. On the bright side, the docks aren't the defensive nightmare I was afraid they'd be. Plenty of good choke points, blind corners, and elevated positions.
Hutbreaker doesn't want an invasion, so Narlok's only allowed to bring a limited deployment. He's rounding up his best troops now.
Got a lot of practice working on droids on Osus, so I'll help Junker modify his service droids to help us fight. In the meantime, I sent Arn to stake out the Brothers' territory and watch for Imperial activity. If they send anyone after us, we'll know.
How is Arn handling his lessons?
He's a quick study. Much better than he thinks he is. Honestly, once he learns to believe in himself, he'll be fine.
And what about you? How do you feel about being his teacher?
It's not as bad as I was afraid it'd be. I think the old man just gave me an easy one to start off with. But I have to admit, he was right. Teaching someone else really helps solidify the basics for yourself, you know? Helps you focus on what's important.
We best get moving. Let us know how it goes with the crew leaders, huh?
If you need anything, just say the word and we'll be there.
Showed up. I prefer doing business here. Better drinks, no dress code, industrial waste disposal in the back if there's trouble.
Let's pick up where we left off at the party.
Well, let's start here. What exactly do you want from me?
The Republic fleet has to get that fuel. I want you to vote to sell it to them.
I get it. You want to buy my vote. Very upstanding. Well, everything's for sale at the right price. You know how this works. You do a little something for me first, and I'll consider it.
What did you have in mind?
You know that slimy little Rhodian Vink? Runs a smuggling crew? He's been raising prices on me, and I'm sick of it. Profits are thin enough without that bug-eyed scammer button in. I want him and his bodyguards dead. No witnesses. No chance the Darmander gets the blame. I know the guy who's next in line. Done business together. He'll hire some of my guys as bodyguards and I'll be in a nice spot. So, there it is. Take out Vic, and the vote's yours.
No deal. I won't be your assassin.
Your call. Oh, good luck getting them votes. I'll be here if you reconsider.
Que faculdade, ou pora, je outro caquice. Ma que puna male tuta, ou misca.
Indigo was willing to vote my way in exchange for killing you.
Ota, titok maki chisa, chubala wawuni. Kafstu undile, jingo hola lukuta. Pakuta pal kuchapting wampa, la agua kilia jikoska. Chonki faguta di opora geoto kakise. Ni ap umpampa boshura moki.
Who do you support?
Akmanoya no chaita. Tuta mishka no chaita. Umpakambak ni jitonka giliski chanaka. Buna nakachu ne tutubuga. Kusa mala chikuta, ikosa mose ala tuta. Patoga wa ki kuba kile.
What exactly do you need?
Udi este nuka. Umpa bituala betuala ni bobo. Oya tuka change kapula. Dimote ki kasa, dobuni lis di oto. Bampaula kava di otto. Umpa bituala betuala ni bobo.
You want to do business with the huts?
Bagsra wana waka. Mibunawa di te utwipi. Kasu yali koyaran kenka kurum. Umpa ta di tok maki chisa chubala wawuni.
I didn't know the exchange was on, Mekshaw.
Kuchuso, Yumata Chikotoya. Mantahumpa, Mulira Favaba. Umpa Bitwala, Bitwama Nibobo. Nokta Chulna Dobela. Patogawa, Kiku Bakili.
I'm not here to take down the exchange, but I'll rescue the envoy.
Kuchuso, Yumata Chikotoya. Cha, Aita Yechopa. Mitwana Shoto.
Kappa Mechispa.
You weren't invited to this meeting, Commander.
I gather your meeting with Veek is cancelled then.
I must say, I am surprised Veek chose his reputation over saving a potential deal with the Huts.
Is the exchange helping the Huts take back Mekshaw? Why else would you let the exchange grow so quickly?
In truth, both of our organizations lose millions of credits to Harido Wald every month. It's getting expensive. Once Veek and his ilk are out of the way, we'll divvy up his roots and cruise between ourselves.
So, Yumata Chikotoya. Mikushu Funbu Dopa Makma.
Dead. It was an ambush. She was working with the exchange all along.
Bampaula Kavaji Oto.
The Huts and the exchange made a deal to kill you and split your resources between themselves. They didn't count on anyone else getting involved.
Kasuyali Koyaran Kenka Kurum. Umpa Kambak, Niji Tonka Giliski Chanaka. Umpa Bitwala, Bitwala Nibobo.
It seems that will take some time.
Dimuti Kikasa, Dubuni Lis Diwoto. Kusa Malachikuta, Ikosa Mose Alachuta. Umpa Bitwala, Bitwala Nibobo. Ridok Bamba, Unaguta, Tanquekuta.
I have other priorities right now. Yes, that should be all.
Inigu daiji liska chanangawa. Jiji haku.
Arn, is that you?
Listen, I need your help. There are slaves. Dozens of them. The brothers are loading them into shuttles. Imperial shuttles. We have to stop them.
I'm on my way.
Thank you. We can't just let this happen.
Ah!
Arn.
They're slavers. Monsters. The worst scum in the galaxy. But I don't want to kill them. I didn't want to kill any of them. I had to. They didn't give me any other choice, did they? There was no other way to get to the slaves and free them before it was too late. What else could I do? Was there some other way? Please, I have to know. You have to tell me.
I wasn't here, Arn. You were. You made the call, and you saved those people.
But that's the problem. I made the call. No one else, just me. Dao doesn't know, but when I was injured, the people we were fighting, they were slavers too. Back then, I couldn't stop them. Years of recovery and pain. Maybe I didn't want there to be another way. Maybe I saw my chance to get payback, and I took it. I don't think that's who I am. I don't want that to be who I am. But part of me is glad they're dead.
We all feel that pull from the dark side sometimes. It's part of the Force, part of all of us. But it doesn't control you, unless you let it.
You're right. Thank you. Thank you. We should get out of here before more reinforcements show up. The slaves are safe. Let's go.
You didn't just hit the brothers, you practically wiped them out! We're supposed to be keeping the peace!
I'll sort that out with Arn myself. Honestly, the galaxy won't miss a pack of slavers, and neither will I.
You think I care that those creeps are gone? I'd give you a medal if I could. It's Hutbreaker who wants our hides over it.
Is she still willing to sell us the fuel?
Yes, for an extra 40%.
Then let's stick to the mission, and let me handle Arn, all right?
How is Arn?
He's still struggling, but I've been there. I'll help him through. He'll hold his post when the time comes.
The vote went in our favor, so I've got the fleet organized and ready to start refueling. Safe bet the imps will show up as soon as we start. So we'd better get ourselves into position right away. I'll meet you all here at the docks.
Hey, hold up. We need to talk. I might be new to being a teacher, but I can't help my student at all if nobody tells me when he's in trouble. You should have called me when Arn contacted you. Helping him is my job, and I deserve the chance to do it.
You're right, Tao. I owe you an apology. It won't happen again.
Thank you. I just want to help him as best I can. Same as you.
My best troops. Wish I could bring more, but we're on thin ice with Hutbreaker as it is.
There are three main approaches the imps could use for their assault. The main catwalks, the maintenance tunnels, or the docks themselves via shuttle.
The main catwalk is the most direct route, so we'll have our strongest defense there. Commander, that's you.
All right, what about the other routes?
Arn and I would be best for the tunnels. In close quarters like that, they'll never make it past our lightsabers.
My droids know those tunnels better than anyone. I'll send them to back you up.
My troops will cover the docks as best they can. But our anti-aircraft weapons are limited. Once our ships start refueling, weapons and docking bays are disabled.
Oyaduka Changi Kapula. Ni af umbamba boshura moki. Kafstu undile. Jigo hola lukuta. Ni af umbamba boshura moki.
Will Hutbreaker be angry about you stepping in like this?
Chonki faguta ji obora jeoto kakise. Oyaduka change kapula. Koba ne puta taise jeskusku.
Sounds like we're ready.
May the Force be with us all.
We can do this! We must do this. For the Republic! It's over. Drop your weapon.
It's been a long day, my friend. I'm doing what I came here to do. Don't make me kill you first.
I've never seen better timing in my life.
You? You're the Alliance Commander.
Guess we're done then. If you can kill the Sith Emperor, I don't really like my odds.
Mission now. Banter later.
Narlok is here. They were trying to activate the failsafe, but we stopped them in time.
We've got them on the run down here.
That's all clear.
Outstanding work, everyone. Let's regroup outside.
We did it! We actually did it!
Combined with the fleet from Onderon, our odds of victory are climbing. Vice Admiral Narlok, I look forward to seeing you at the rendezvous. Please set out as soon as possible.
Of course, General. Thank you all. You saved my ships. And you may have saved the whole of the Republic.
I'm glad I had the chance to work with you again, Narlok.
Who could have imagined us standing here together all those years ago? I just hope we can meet once more when Corellia is safe.
Thanks to your heroism, the Republic will have enough ships to challenge Malgus's armada when they arrive at Corellia. But numbers are no guarantee of victory, and our foe is known for his cunning. You have my coordinates. Meet me right away. The battle is about to begin.
Well, it's been a bucket of fun. But these old bones need a good 3 or 4 day nap. Stay spry, kids. Junkers out.
Thank Hutbreaker and the others for us.
Yeah.
No sign of Char anywhere on Mekshaw. She might have died on one of the shuttles that Narlok's troop shot down.
Or she bailed as soon as the fight didn't go her way. That would definitely fit her profile.
What do you think about this prisoner, Anri? Will we get anything useful out of her?
She seemed to be a key part of the Empire's plans. She might know a lot.
Every little bit helps, especially with what we're up against. I guess we'll see you at the rendezvous. This will be my first time back on Corellia since the last time. I can't believe it's been so long.
You're not the same person you were back then, Tao. You'll do fine.
Let's hope you're right. See you there, Commander.
Leaving already? No time to stop for a few drinks.
What? Seriously?
No. Come on.
You really do have a way with people.
We received coordinates for your strategy meeting with General Derun. They included rather explicit instructions that only you should attend.
I can't imagine why they wouldn't be comfortable sharing their battle plans with some of your friends.
How could they turn away a charming renegade spy like you?
Well, when you put it that way, it makes even more sense. Good thing you're a lot more fun.
The shuttle is ready when you are.
Commander, welcome. Let's get started right away.
Of course. I'm sure time isn't on our side.
It so rarely is. Galena Rands, I'm the Supreme Chancellor of the Republic. But don't hold that against me.
It's an honor to meet you, Chancellor.
Honor's all mine. Haven't gotten to come to a briefing like this since my time in the 439th Bomber Wing.
This is Fleet Admiral Newman. He'll be commanding naval aspects of Corellia's defense.
A challenge, to be sure, but thanks to the reinforcements we've received, one that we can overcome.
All right, then. How do we defend Corellia? How do we save the Meridian Complex shipyard?
The captured Dark Counselor, Darth Savick, revealed much about the enemy fleet's capabilities. But she didn't know their attack plan. I've positioned our ships for maximum flexibility. Rapid reaction is our best hope.
How can the Alliance fleet help with the battle?
I'd like to keep them hidden on the far side of the planet Talus. Once we've seen the Empire's strategy, they can hyperjump in wherever they'll be most effective. Savick has also revealed that the Imperial Armada will include a group of dreadnoughts equipped with Isotope 5 generators, and another with silencer superweapons.
Meaning?
The Isotope 5 ships will be much faster than standard, with far stronger shields. The silencers can destroy capital ships in a single shot.
What do we have that can go up against weapons like those?
We had hoped Admiral Revald's null cannons would be available in time, but the prototypes are still too unstable to deploy.
All right, that's everything in orbit. How about planet side?
Anti-aircraft turrets and defensive shielding are already in place. So long as they remain operational, the facility will be safe from aerial attack.
And our ground forces?
We've deployed as many soldiers as possible to the Meridian complex, but it was built as a shipyard, not a fortress. We can only station so many troops in the facility before we end up leaving them exposed. So, the rest are positioned as close by as possible.
I've gathered as many Jedi as I could to join the defense, including volunteers from Corellia's Green Jedi. But there are still too few to repel a significant Sith contingent. Commander, we'd like you and your Alliance forces to join the ground defense group and help tip the odds in our favor.
We'll be ready for anything the Empire throws at us.
Sounds like everyone knows their job. The Republic's counting on you, friends. If we're gonna put up a decent fight going forward, we need that shipyard. Make us all proud.
Safe travels. Numen out.
We'll make our way to Corellia in my personal ship. There should be just enough time to cook up a nice rishkate and a pot of gadolinium before we arrive.
Tau informed me of Arn's difficulties on Meksha. It meant a lot to her that you understood her concerns in being excluded from the situation. Recognizing when help is needed can be very important, but recognizing who should be giving that help, that can be even more important.
I should have given Tau the chance to help. She's actually doing a very good job with Arn.
Just as I expected. Now then, enough talk. We have a battle to win, don't we? Not to mention, I was in a Bacta tank the last time Daerun brewed this tea of his. I want to see what all the fuss is about. But you must admit, it's hardly the Sith approach.
I've grown far stronger working beside her than I ever could have become through treachery.
Intriguing. I suppose the Sith Code never specifically calls for the usurpation of the Master by the Apprentice. Merely the pursuit of greater power.
Precisely. It's only natural that the strongest should lead, but the goal should be strength, not necessarily leadership. If one is truly strong, leadership comes inevitably.
A unique point of view among the Sith.
Perhaps that's why we aren't among the Sith now.
Is everyone ready to land at the shipyard?
We are indeed. Shuttles are prepped and gear is stowed.
Exiting hyperspace in the Corellia system, now.
Groups 4 and 5, position Org 9. 6, 7, and 8, stagger column behind them.
Daerun here, report.
The enemy arrived ahead of schedule. They're split into three groups we've designated Hound, Raptor, and Swarm.
Energy signatures tell us Hound group contains the Isotope 5 dreadnoughts. They're approaching our lines head-on at maximum speed.
Following behind, Raptor group, vertical halo formation to maximize field of fire. The silencers, covering Hound group's approach. Swarm group contains the bulk of the attacking fleet. It dropped out of hyperspace on the far side of the planet, well out of weapons range. Objective, unknown.
Understood. How can we help?
Approach in the vector we're sending now to avoid Raptor Group's targeting range. Then make for the surface.
Admiral, it's Swarm Group. The vessel opened fire.
Opened fire on what? We're out of range.
They aren't firing on us. They're firing on the surface, the cities, residential, manufacturing. It's totally indiscriminate.
We have to stop them. Thousands. Even millions could die.
Redeploying any of our ships will weaken our defensive blockade significantly. There is the Alliance fleet, but we need them to trap the silencers.
Forget the plan. Those people need us. Admiral Ego, get to the far side of Corellia. Stop the Imperials any way you can.
Copy that. Moving out.
What the? Reading multiple new targets. They must have been hidden by Hound's energy signatures.
They're going to beat us to the surface. All shuttles, prepare for launch.
A wave of Imperial dropships beat us to the surface. We're in for a fight.
Finally, solid ground. Nice flying. Arn, are you ready?
I'm ready.
We'll follow your lead.
Time to kick the Empire off Corellia for good.
All teams report in. Everyone make it groundside.
Our team is all right. We've passed the outer defenses.
All clear in our sector. We're heading for a tram pylon nearby. Jorgen wants to set up a sniper perch.
Good here too. Taking a more subtle approach. If I say it over the comm, it would kind of defeat the purpose.
It's just business as usual here.
That's, good to hear. Stay in contact. Out.
Imperials, this battle, seeing it all in person, it's a lot to take in.
Don't let the chaos break your focus. The Force will guide you through it all, if you let it.
I'll try.
Position and try to head them off.
Do you need help?
We'll back her up. You keep moving.
Quite a team you've got. Should we help them?
We've handled a lot of crazy situations over the years. They'll be fine.
Enemy units encountered in Sector 8. Requesting backup at my location.
Yeah.
pulling down air support on their location.
The last ISO 5 dreadnought is regrouped with the rest of the imps. Can anyone assist?
Leave them to us. Mandoade, prepare for boarding.
Darth Malgus has been spotted leading an attack group toward the control center. We have to hurry! We're doing our best to hold off the imps, but a few units have gone past us. They were heading toward the auxiliary shield controls on the 30th floor. Immediate backup! Repeat! Malgus has...
All clear?
All clear.
You saved me. Thank you. Thank you! It's you. After all these years, you came to rescue me.
Tharren, is it really you?
Of course it's me. Who else would the Republic trust to build a state-of-the-art facility chock-full of cutting-edge exotechnology?
Wait, his name's Tharren, too?
But if you didn't know I was here, then you must be here to stop the Imperials, I suppose. Which is good, too.
I'm very glad to see you again. But yes, it's crucial that we stop the Imperials.
Luckily, I can help.
Commander! Tau, Arn.
We're all right, old man.
And this is...
Tharren Sedrax, foremost authority on exotechnology and principal systems engineer of this once fine facility.
Where's Darth Malgus?
Ah, you'll be quite proud of me. I diverted him when I calculated that our physical security was insufficient. I rerouted all facility defense systems to a secondary control station near the top of the spire.
Clever as always. Well done.
Now that you're here, this battle will undoubtedly turn in our favor. The Sith Lord, Malgus, he and the last of his troops set off up the elevators toward the secondary controls. You're not too late to stop them.
If you read me, you better hunker down. Some of the reinforcements got past us and they are not in a great mood.
We can hold this level with our troops. You three, go on. Malgus must be stopped.
Come with us, we can fight him together.
No, seeing me alive will only fuel his rage even further. This is your fight, all three of you. Fight as one, and you can defeat him. May the Force be with you.
Malgus!
hoped it would be you. I've been looking forward to this. And Towered Air, didn't you bring that old fool with you? I'm told he survived our last encounter.
Not even you can win this one. Drop your weapon. It's over.
Is it?
Alert! Shield power decreasing. Shield system failure imminent.
Shall we die together?
You think we'd give up so easily?
I think I will kill you easily.
Think again.
I should have known it wasn't just a story. If anyone could destroy him, it was you. No matter. I will not fail. Your shipyard will crumble. Your republic will burn. Will not fail.
Shield system failure. Structural damage detected. Evacuation protocols in effect. Shield power restored. Structural support units deployed. Fire suppression systems activated. External defensive systems restored. Targeting hostiles. Now!
All forces, our assault has failed. The shields cannot be penetrated. Regroup. group at Ivy Point Crash. Now.
We did it. All ships, regroup at the Meridian Complex. Secure any remaining enemy forces on the surface and prepare search and rescue teams for deployment. We've won the impossible battle. But the day isn't over until we've gotten everyone home safely. Get to it.
Conquering hero. You saved the day again. Well done.
It wasn't easy, but we pulled it off.
We're getting a mountain of good intel out of the captured soldiers and ship crews, not to mention data from the wreckage. Exciting times, but I won't keep you. Just wanted to pass on my congratulations. See you around.
Well, if it isn't one of my new favorite people.
Tau escaped with only minor injuries. She'll be along shortly. Arn's recovery will take longer, but he'll be all right.
All Corellia forces are still on alert, but it would seem Malgus has escaped us once again.
One miss in a day full of hits. We'll get him eventually. The production lines are firing back up in a matter of days. We'll get new ships to our frontline units in no time. The Empire committed a lot to this attack. They're going to be hurting for a while, and we'll be ready to press the advantage. We've spent a lot of time with our backs to a wall. It will be good to finally take the initiative. Couldn't agree more. So what am I supposed to do with you? The hero of the Republic who's not in the Republic. At least not for some years now.
I believe there's a simple solution, Chancellor.
I agree. Consider this your formal invitation, Commander. Come back to us. Join the Republic. And bring all your friends and your planet with you.
All of my people? You know that some of them were part of the Sith Empire.
I do. And if you are willing to give them a chance, then so am I. Odessen becomes a member world of the Republic, with a senator and everything. Every one of your people, even the ones with criminal charges or intelligence files with frowny faces on them, they all get clean records and citizenship if they want it. What's more, you'll be heading a new initiative we're cooking up. One I think you'll like. General?
Task Force Nova, a joint military and civilian effort to help the Jedi rebuild their order.
My research suggests that there are still countless Jedi scattered across the galaxy. We will find them, and we will build them a new home.
You're not planning to rebuild on Tython?
Tython will remain a stronghold of the Jedi, but we have been separated from the rest of the galaxy for too long. Our new home should be found amongst the people of the Republic, not hidden away. Rebuilding the Jedi means rebuilding the Jedi High Council. I can think of no one I would rather welcome as this new council's first member. Your unique experiences and wisdom must be documented for future generations. A crucial task for the Master of Hidden Knowledge.
I'll be your liaison with the Republic military. We'll provide security, reconnaissance, and intelligence support.
That's quite an offer. Of course, if you'd rather keep the Alliance as it is, that's fine too. You'll still be our top ally, and we'll still want your help with the task force. But the rest, the titles, the areas of responsibility, that's all a package deal for signing up. So, back to the Republic and the Jedi, or stick with the Alliance as is. I've worked hard to build the Alliance. I'm not ready to give that up. Fair enough.
Though you may not be an official Jedi any longer, we still welcome your insights.
Until next time.
Commander.
Task Force Nova. An impressive undertaking. I'm surprised it took the Republic this long to prioritize the revitalization of the Jedi. Our own forces came out of the battle largely unscathed. We'll be back to full operational readiness in a matter of days. The Alliance remains a force to be reckoned with. Maintaining our independence ensures our operational flexibility. You've made the right choice.
When I hit the cantina, I heard about a general who's buying rounds for anyone with good Corellia stories. Suddenly, I care less about drinks.
Hey, need a minute of your time.
Catch up with you later.
Arn is still in the med bay on one of the corvettes. They didn't want to risk moving him. Still a lot of work to do. I tried to help him as we fell, to reach out in the Force, but we just weren't synced up. Even so, we both survived against Darth Malgus. That wouldn't have happened if you hadn't been there. Thanks.
Do you know how long it will be before Arn is on his feet again?
Weeks, probably. They might have to bring in a specialist from Daycot 7 to help with the cybernetics. Apparently they're pretty complex. There's one other thing we should talk about. When Arn and I were buried in all of that wreckage, we didn't dig ourselves out. We had help.
From who?
From them.
Kira Carson, Jedi Knight.
Lord Scourge, not a Jedi Knight.
You attacked me on Mech Shah.
And I gladly apologize. It was a necessary test.
A test that you passed. What are you talking about?
The Emperor, Tenebrae, Vitiate, Valkorion, whatever his name. He was a part of you. We all felt his destruction, but he has always been a master of deceit. We had to be sure that he wasn't lingering in your mind, hidden, waiting to come out only in the most dire circumstances. Now, we are sure.
If you were testing me, it must have been for a reason.
We believe you might be the only one who can help us.
We can't risk saying more here. Let's travel to your base on Odessen. It should be safe for us to talk there.
About what?
The final gruesome weapon of Tenebrae.
We're here. Now tell me what this is all about.
As I told you on Carrick Station, Tenebrae's last gruesome weapon. He sought immortality, but only his endless spite survives now. I was his most powerful servant once. His wrath. But I learned of his true nature and plotted his downfall for centuries. Ultimately, I saw what had to be done, and betrayed my empire in order to destroy its creator. That is how I came to fight alongside Kira.
We fought the Emperor's servants constantly for years.
We even thought we'd beaten him alongside my master. Then Yavin 4 happened. And Valkorion.
I received guidance from an old ally. Instead of seeking out our enemy in his current shell, you, as it turns out. We sought a different target. Tenebrae hid his original body where no one could harm it. As long as that body remained in stasis, the galaxy's greatest evil could never truly be killed.
Unless we destroyed Tenebrae, the fight against Valkorion would never really be over.
Since Valkorion is gone, I assume you succeeded.
We did. As we later learned, we destroyed his first body just as you purged the last vestige of his twisted spirit from your mind. That is when his final weapon was unleashed. A Sith ritual, carved into his very flesh, unleashed an ancient plague from every molecule of his decaying corpse.
We were both knocked out cold, comatose for more than a year. Satil Shan was the one who finally pulled us out of that nightmare. And started a new one.
Like you, Kira and I have both been vessels for a portion of Tenebrae's power. It acted as a sort of vaccine. But Satil had no such protection, nor did any of her followers. Within days, they were all laid low, trapped in a nightmarish slumber. In helping us, they unknowingly doomed themselves.
I've dealt with a Force plague before. I'm sure I can help you.
That's great to hear, but there's more.
The infection is worsening. There is a darkness growing among the afflicted.
We can feel their minds connecting, communicating. We're afraid they might be merging somehow.
Merging into what? Another Valkorion? Is this plague bringing him back somehow?
It's too early to make that conclusion. Whatever it is immensely dangerous. We must stop it.
How?
We loaded Satil and all of her followers onto a transport to keep them quarantined, along with a few medroids to tend to them. The transport is programmed to fly a random course through unsettled sectors of the Outer Rim, all weeks away from civilization. I can send a signal to alter the course, bring it to another empty system that's closer so that we can meet it in a shuttle.
We board the ship. And connect our minds with yours through the Force. Together, we will face this entity and purge it from existence. And if we cannot purge it, then we destroy the transport and hope we've ended the old monster's schemes forever.
Send the signal. If what you say is true, this thing could be getting stronger by the minute.
I'll send the signal right away. It'll take a while for the transport to come back into range. Mind if we stay here in the meantime? I'm no crasher. If you need any help while we're waiting, all you have to do is ask.
If it's a matter of fighting in your renewed war, leave me out. I have slain enough of my old comrades for 5 lifetimes.
Old softy.
Ah, child.
I have a good feeling about this. Call if you need me.